Welcome to my channel Lanovate. In this video, we will going to discuss about the secretion and functions of the different male secondary SSH glands. These glands include the seminal vesicles, the prostate gland, and the bulbourethral gland. Will going to contribute to the secretion of the semen that contain 90-95% of these secretions of these three glands, and 2% of the spermatozoa are present in the semen. So we will going to discuss the function and secretion of each gland one by one. So starting from the secretion and function of all the SSH glands, here you can see in these notes I have put up all these functions. So starting from the definition and what are the description about these sac glands. The total volume of semen released as a result of ejaculation contain about 2-5% of the sperms, while the other 90% is formed by the secretion of these sac glands. So only 2-5% is contributed through the sperms, while all the other secretion, about 90%, is formed by the secretion of these sac glands. And all the secretion of these sac glands, that are the prostate, seminal vesicles, and the bulbourethral gland, are under the control of the male sac hormone, that is your testosterone. So these secretions are under the control of testosterone and they vary in their contribution. Now coming to the function of each SSH gland, starting from the seminal vesicle. So seminal vesicles that produce a yellowish alkaline fluid. It means that the pH of this fluid is greater than 7.5. Coming to its contribution, it make up about 60-70% of the seminal fluid. That is the largest contribution provided by the seminal vesicles in the semen. The third function is that the secretory product of the seminal vesicle contain fructose, citric acid, prostaglandins, and fibrinogen. The fibrinogen is for the clotting. It's for the clotting of the semen, while the fructose is a major nutrition to the semen. So the secretion make the nutrition available for the sperm because this secretion contain the fructose. And the fibrinogen is acting as a clotting factor, while the citric acid and prostaglandin were also going to act on the sperm maturation and on the clotting and nutrition of the sperm. That is provided by the seminal vesicles that contribute about 60-70% of the seminal fluid. Now coming to the prostate gland. The prostate gland is anatomically one of the largest SSH sac gland, and its contribution to the semen is only about 30%. So the 30% secretion of the seminal fluid is from the prostate gland. The prostate gland secretes a thin, milky, alkaline fluid that contains. This fluid is also milky and alkaline because the acidity of vagina is neutralized by the prostate gland. So, this will going to produce alkaline fluid. This prostate gland fluid contains the calcium, citric acid, phosphate, and profibrinolysin. The calcium, citric acid, and phosphate are the ions, and they are going to perform as an inorganic function and in the maturation of the sperm, while the profibrinolysin is an enzyme that will going to convert into the fibrinolysin and will going to break the clot that is formed through the seminal vesicle fluid. So the profibrinolysin is released from the prostate gland and will going to break the clot. The prostatic secretion changes the pH of the vagina from 3.5 to pH of 6.5. It means it making the vaginal fluid alkaline. So it will going to neutralize the acidity of vagina and making the pH of 6.5, that is favorable for sperm maturation. So this was all about the prostate gland. Now coming to the last gland, that is a smaller gland, but also it contribute to about 5-10% of the secretion, and this is your bulbourethral gland. Anatomically, the bulbourethral gland is a very short pea-sized gland and present in the deep perineal pouch in the perineum. So this bulbourethral gland is going to contribute about 5-10% of the secretion, and the secretion of bulbourethral gland is about thick mucoid. It secretes the mucus. The function of mucus is only to make the semen smooth, only to make the pathway of the sperm smooth, so sperm and the semen can move easily and ejaculate at the time of ejaculation. So the bulbourethral gland is a major contribution for the mucus. So this was all about all three glands we have just discussed, the seminal vesicles, the prostate, and the bulbourethral gland, that are making up about 90-95% of the seminal secretion. So I hope you'll be explained well. Thank you for watching. Subscribe for more. Like, share, and comment below. Thank you.